Hey guys, this is Charles Jaeger for Tuts Plus, and today I'm going to be showing you how to create some realistic looking refraction in After Effects with Element 3D. Let's take a look at what we're going to be creating. As we see here, Element does a great job of refracting the environment that we have in our scene, such as in this example with the splash of water and the environment behind it. However, Element doesn't refract any of the other group objects that we might have behind liquid, like in this example here with the gun behind the splash. The liquid now almost looks as if it's a chrome type surface and dense because we can't see the gun through the liquid. So I'm going to be showing you guys a technique that makes it look a lot more realistic and will actually refract the other Element objects behind the splash. Let's get to it. In After Effects, first thing I'm going to do is create a new composition. I'm going to call this my main scene. Alright, I'm going to want to create a new solid. Call it Element. And apply Element. Alright, let's jump into the scene setup. Alright, I'm going to create a scene similar to the one we saw in that video with a gun and the splash in front of it. Get the gun model, have it on group 1. Now if we move into the motion design pack, and if you don't have this from videocopilot.net, I'm sure you can find many other liquid splash OBJs online. Just Google, see what you can come up with. I like the liquids in here, and I particularly like liquid number 3. It has a good splash, it's going to work really well for what we're trying to do. Alright, down in the presets in the Pro Shaders pack, if you have that, you're going to want to apply the Translucent Clear preset. This is a good liquid preset that has some texture on it that looks pretty good. If you don't have this, you can always go and apply the Glass preset. It'll be pretty similar. You're going to want to put this on Group 2 and hit OK. Alright, let's create a new camera. And I'm going to hit C to navigate around the scene here. Alright, now I'm going to move the splash in front of the gun like it was in that other video. And there we go. That should work well for what we're trying to do. Alright, the next thing I'm going to do is create the camera movement. So I'm going to create a keyframe here in the front, move down about 3 seconds, and move it off to the side here. And there we go. Okay, we're going to be making some duplicate copies of Element. So what you're going to want to do before we do that is basically get all your settings finalized so you don't have to go through each layer of Element later and change everything. So what I'm going to do is just select one of the preset light setups. You can set up your own lights if you want to, but I'm just going to use one of the presets for the sake of time. Okay, I'm going to select the natural light that looks probably the best. And down here, another setting you're going to want to turn on is in the output. You're going to want to set your super sampling up to 2. That's going to give us a lot cleaner edges. And if your machine can't handle that, or at least right now when working it, you might want to turn this to preview, and that's what I'm going to do as well. Okay, let's close that up. Alright, like I said, we're going to be duplicating the element layer. We're also going to duplicate the camera. So what you're going to want to do is control click on both of those and then hit control D on the keyboard. It's going to duplicate them both. And let's go up here to layer and pre-compose. And we're going to call this refraction. Hit OK. I'm going to move that directly above the element layer. And let's jump into that scene. Okay, in here we're going to duplicate Element one more time. And the top copy of Element, we're going to name it Splash Matte. We're going to select the bottom copy and hit Enter to rename. We're going to call this just the gun. And on this top copy, on the Splash Matte, let's jump into Scene Setup. We can delete the gun now. And on our liquid, go down to Presets in the Standard Materials. You're going to select Flat Color and apply that. Let's also change it to black and hit OK. And for the gun layer, we're going to go to scene setup and close off the liquid and just hit OK. All right, so now you can kind of get an idea of what we're going to do. We have the two element objects now on their own element layers. And if we go down here on this bottom gun layer, you're going to want to go to the track mat. And if you can't see that, you may hit F4 to toggle the switches. You're going to want to select Alpha Matte. And what this is going to do is a pretty cool effect. We're only going to be able to see the gun when it was behind our splash element layer. And it's kind of trippy when you scroll through it here. It has a pretty neat effect, but like I said, you can only see the gun now where it was overlapped by the splash layer. So if we jump back into our main scene, we can kind of see something's going on here now. We can actually see the gun behind our splash or through it. So if we go to our main element layer in the main scene, go down to our environment and click Show Background. Now if we scroll through it, really starting to see something now. Okay, on the refraction layer, let's go over to Mode and select Hard Light. What this is going to do is show some of the darker detail of the water ripples on top of the gun, and it's going to make it look a lot better. All right, let's jump back into the refraction composition. On the gun element layer, let's apply some color correction. I'm gonna apply curves effect. All right, let's bump up the contrast a bit. Let's jump back into our main scene. What this kind of looks like now is like the light is going through the water and kind of making the gun brighter behind it, so we can kind of see some separation from this and this. All right, back on the gun layer, let's apply turbulent displace. And what this is gonna kind of do is emulate the water distortion of the gun through the splash. If we zoom in here, we can kind of scroll through and see that kind of wavy, watery look. All right, let's jump back into our main scene. And there we go. If we scroll through, it definitely looks a lot more realistic. And now we can see the gun through the splash. We're not getting that chrome look. Let's look at before here, which, like I said, the refraction on the edges of the water looks great, but it does look kind of chrome. So if we turn this back on, definitely looks a lot better. Now one thing you may notice is we kind of have these edges here that show up on the splash, and it's kind of a result of the track mat that we applied. So there's two ways we can fix that. The first one is if we jump back in our element layer and scroll all the way to the bottom, set this back to full render, and that's going to give us that super sampling we applied earlier, and jump into your refraction comp, and also change that for all the instances of element that you have. Set that back to full render. And something else I just remembered that we're going to want to do is turn on motion blur for all of these element layers, so the splash mat and the gun. If we jump back into our main scene, set that motion blur on as well. And when we turn motion blur on, that will also kind of get rid of that edge line, or at least make the light look like it's wrapping around the splash a lot better. And that's pretty much it. Let's do a RAM preview real quick. And there we go. A much more realistic looking refraction, all in Element 3D. Obviously it's not true refraction, but it does look pretty realistic compared to what it looked like before. Okay, there's one more situation you may run into when trying this effect. We jump over into this other scene I have preset up here. What I've got is, in this example, I've got a element object, a watch in this case, with the same splash we just saw, but below. So it actually kind of wraps around the watch. And one of the problems that can arise with a splash like this that actually wraps around your object Let's take a look at this picture here. Okay, on this picture here, we can see that if we tried the same matte technique that we did before on this instance, the refraction will work perfect on the front of the watch where the splash is actually in front of it. But if you look at the back wristband of the watch, we can see that there's these dark splotches. And what that's from is the matte of the splash is still working on the drops that are actually behind the watch. And we don't want that. So I'm gonna show you guys a technique that can fix that. All right, if we jump into the refraction composition that I've already pre-built for this watch layer in the exact same manner I did for the gun. So what I've got inside here is the elements separated onto two element layers. You got the splash mat, which has the liquid, and the watch layer, which has just the watch. So what we want to do is jump into the splash mat scene setup of element. We're going to go to the primitives and add the flat box. Set that on group 3, hit OK. And I'm going to go to the custom view on the side here. And so basically what we want is to matte only the splash that's in front of the watch, because that's what's going to be actually be refracting the watch behind it. This liquid back here doesn't really matter what we do to it, because it's just going to refract the environment map that's already in element anyway. So what we can do is on this group here with the flat box, we're going to rotate it 90 degrees, move it up in Z space, kind of in front of the watch. So about right here. I'm going to hit C to navigate around. So the only water that we really care about is in front of the watch. Now let's jump back into the scene setup. And on the flat box, if we go to the materials, we're going to want to apply the matte shadow. This is pretty cool. If we go back to our active camera, so as you can see, this kind of creates a matte on our splash so that we only see the liquid that's in front of the watch, because like I said, the liquid behind it doesn't really matter. So now if we turn on our track matte for the watch element layer, set it on alpha, now we can see the watch showing up over the splash, but only on the splash that was in front of it. So let's go back to our main layer. Let's turn on our refraction layer and set it to hard light. And now we can see that only the liquid that's in front of the watch is refracting. The actual watch and the liquid that's behind it is not doing anything funny, creating any edges that we don't want, and looks a lot more realistic. I'm gonna jump back into the refraction layer here and on the watch, turn on curves and a turbulent displace. If we jump back over, now we can really start to see refraction on the watch there. What's going on, and everything back here looks just fine. All right, guys, that's all I got for you for the refraction in Element 3D. I will leave you with this one last tip. If you created any lights initially in your main scene, you're also going to want to copy those into your refraction composition so that you have the same light set up in both of your element scenes and your models will look the exact same. This has been Charles Jaeger for Tuts Plus. Thanks for watching.